Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, coming to you with another Impossible Science, the show where we take an impossible topic and we bring it to life through science. Now, today's experiment is extremely cool because it has to do with glass, and anybody who knows me knows I really like to work with transparent items. So today, I'm going to go over the science of why do we see an object, why do we see through objects, and how can we use that science to turn an object invisible. So let's take a closer look. Reflection is what lets you see yourself in a mirror. Light hits your face, scatters away in all directions, and when that light hits a mirror, some of that light is reflected back into your eyes. But when you look at your reflection in a window, you look transparent. This is because some of the light reflects back, but not as much as a mirror. Whenever light goes from one clear substance into another, some of the light is reflected if the speed of light is different in the two substances. Because light slows down when it goes from air into glass, the inner window surface reflects some light. When it goes from inside the glass back into the air outside, another reflection happens. As it speeds up again, we are seeing the reflected light. But if the speed of light inside does not change as it enters or leaves two different materials, no light is reflected. No light reflected means we cannot see that object. Now we understand why when light travels from one transparent material into another transparent material, some light makes it through and some light is reflected, and the light that's reflected is what we're seeing. Now, especially if there's a change in speed of light inside the material, there's going to be a greater reflection. Now, scientists have taken the time to figure out the ratio of the speed of light in different transparent materials, and they call this the refractive index. Speed of light in a vacuum over the speed of light in the material. So that means the higher the refractive index, the slower the speed of light, and also the greater the reflection. Now, inside this beaker is water. Now, water has a refractive index of about 1.33. Now, I know that doesn't mean much if you haven't really played with refractive index before, but the refractive index of this borosilicate rod is about 1.47 to 1.54. And I say that because I don't really know what's exactly in this glass rod. It's a stirring rod from a chemistry set that I ordered online. But because it's right around that range, I know it'll be visible in the water. That's because the refractive index is different. There's a change in the speed of light inside the glass, which is allowing us to see the reflection of light. Now, in this other beaker, I have corn oil. Now, corn oil has a refractive index of about 1.47. Sound familiar? This roughly has the same index as this borosilicate rod, which means there won't be a change in speed of light as light goes through this oil through this rod. And if there is, it'll be very small and it'll be hard to see. So, take a close look at this as this rod vanishes. So you now know that if there's no change in speed of light, then objects turn invisible, which is why it's so hard to see this other beaker that's inside there too. Now, we can take this experiment a little bit further. I'll get a bigger beaker of corn oil, and this time I'm gonna use a test tube. Now, this test tube is made of borosilicate as well. Now, if I place it inside there, it's very visible. And people say, wait a second, I thought you said that if they had a similar refractive index, they would be invisible. Well, that's true, except this test tube is hollow, which means there's air in it. So now you've got a change in speed of light as light goes through the oil, through the borosilicate glass, through the air, back through the glass, back to the oil. So if I actually take this test tube and I fill it in from the top, as it fills up with oil, okay, so you can still see the test tube. You can see the test tube because it's a different type of glass, and I think it's borosilicate, but it may not be the exact composition as the one I'm holding in my right hand. This rod turns invisible pretty well inside corn oil, and that gave me an idea. What if I could connect these borosilicate rods together by heating them up? Could I melt them into a track? And could I take that track and submerge it into an aquarium and fill the aquarium with corn oil? Then you'd have a track that you can't even see. Check out this awesome idea. This is my invisible ball run. I actually made this track out of borosilicate rods. They've melted together, and I even found a funnel online made of borosilicate. Hopefully it will work as well. The idea is this is a marble track. Yeah, that's right. You can make a marble roll down. And as simple as this looks, it took quite a bit of time to actually make this because it kept breaking on me. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna roll a steel ball bearing down this. Now, here's the idea. If the borosilicate turns invisible, but you can see the steel bearing, you should be able to see the ball move through the aquarium. So all we have to do is fill it up with corn oil and let's see how it turns out. Okay, I ran into a small problem. I let all the air bubbles sit on this corn oil so they could rise out, and some of them caught on the track, which is not helping me. But you can still trace out the glass, and that's not the desired effect I wanted. So, since I can't change the track, I'm gonna change the oil. I'm gonna change it to a mineral oil, which has a very similar refractive index, but it's a little bit different. So hopefully I can camouflage the glass in there, because the desired effect is to see a marble roll down a track you can't see. So let's drain this and let's do it again. All right, so I got the corn oil out and I've got 5 gallons of mineral oil here. Now mineral oil has roughly the same refractive index as corn oil and a little bit different, might be able to help me get this glass to disappear. Now, how cool is this thing? This has got to be one of my favorite experiments of all time. Now, there is still a lot of room to grow with this. For a home experiment of a ball track that's invisible, that proved a point. I couldn't be more excited about it. If you like my goofy experiment and you want to see me take this a little bit further, let me know in the comments below. And if you just enjoy making the impossible possible through science, make sure you like the video, share this video with your friends, because I really appreciate the support. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything. How do we see through an object? And how do we break a glass bottle? So, since I can't change the track, I'm gonna change the oil. This is gonna take a little bit of precision.